Here we have a composite canard from a Beechcraft Starship as a test article, and we are going to demonstrate how AeroPro cross-coupling compensation can reduce the testing time of a fatigue test. The canard is fixed at the base, and loads are applied via two actuators shown. The problem is when one actuator changes load, the other actuator is affected. They are cross-coupled. This is the spectrum we'll be playing out, showing the interactions between the channels. We'll be able to show the channels going in opposite phases and the channels going in phase. These are the optimal commands, and we are hoping to be able to run our test in phase with as limited amount of error as possible. This is the MTS data display, showing signals from the control channels, force on the y-axis, and time on the x-axis. Inboard command is maroon, and this is the desired force that the actuator should produce. Inboard feedback is green, and is the actual force that is being applied. Outboard command is blue. Outboard feedback is pink. The bottom plot shows error on the y-axis and time on the x-axis. Error equals command minus feedback. When running a fatigue test as quickly as possible, the channels will null pace. We will see the software null pacing indicated by these vertical white lines turning on and off. This null pacing is a result of the errors and is used to keep the channels running synchronously as we're applying the load spectrum. Introducing the cross-coupling compensation, we're going to be able to compensate for the channels' interactions, and because of that, we're going to be able to run faster. As we introduce the cross-coupling compensation, we are able to see that the errors are reduced considerably and the null pacing is limited. Because of this, our velocity will increase and our testing time will decrease.